Good morning. Devastation. Severe storms and tornadoes ripped through parts of the Midwest, hitting Indiana hard. With many injured and three dead, many are left to clean up the damage.
The trip of a lifetime. SpaceX announces they will send two private citizens around the moon and back to Earth. When the passengers will go on their space expedition and how many miles they'll travel.
And it's vacation time. Spring break is just hours away. Coming up, we'll have your full spring break forecast.
Plus, we'll have live updates with a group from Ball State that is traveling to baseball spring training in Florida. Get the coffee ready and open up those eyes. You're waking up with Cardinal Weather.
From Ball State Unified Media, you're waking up with a special edition of Cardinal Weather. Countdown to spring break with Molly, Tanner, Emerson, Kaylee, and David, live from the Ball State Weather Center.
And good morning. It's Friday, March 3rd, 2017. You're looking live at Miami, Florida. There's just a few clouds out there. Expected to reach a high of 80, but right now, almost 70 degrees there.
That's right, Tanner. Just a few clouds, 68 degrees right now. Spring break temperatures, it looks like.
Look at that. That looks so nice. Meanwhile, back here in the Ball State Weather Center, welcome to this special spring edition of Cardinal Weather. I'm Tanner Holbrook.
And I'm Emerson Lehman. Thanks for tuning in. Kaylee Plutchel, Molly Coates, and David Seipel will be along with us in just a few minutes.
Yeah, Billy, it may be nice down in Miami, but it sure wasn't nice this past week here in Indiana.
That's right, Tanner. Severe storms ripped through parts of the Midwest Tuesday night into Wednesday morning, creating devastation in parts of Illinois and Indiana. Kaylee is standing by with more.
Yeah, thanks, Emerson and Tanner. This was the scene early Wednesday morning in the small Indiana town of Poiseville. Several homes and buildings were destroyed, and a number of trees fell on the Interstate 69 near the town of Griffin, Indiana, closing part of the highway for some time. And in Illinois community of Crossville, crews found the body of a man who went missing during the storms. Authorities say the man's house was destroyed in the storms, and his wife was hospitalized.
Deadly tornadoes struck communities in the heartland as storms raked across the Midwest Tuesday and into the early morning hours Wednesday. Some areas seeing twisted metal and splintered wood, in others, death and injury. Reed Binion reports.
Come up over the hill and then you've seen all the carnage and the vehicles and the mobile homes.
Officials reacting to damage left in the wake of a deadly tornado that ripped through a community in Missouri Tuesday.
Everything just turned over. I mean, it just looks like a disaster zone. So the only thing to do is just to jump out here and help people and try to do the best you can to get these people back safe, back home to their loved ones.
The Missouri State Patrol says a man was killed while driving down the interstate when a tornado sent up to 20 junkyard vehicles onto the road. That twister just one of many that struck in the heartland as storms raked across the Midwest Tuesday. The National Weather Service reported well over a dozen tornadoes in multiple states, including Iowa, where a funnel cloud was captured on camera. Twisters also ravaging Illinois, where authorities say a man was killed by a falling tree. Storms also bringing damaging hail the size of baseballs in some cases. The severe weather causing not only death and injury, but massive damage as well.
We could hear the hail hitting the door of the storm cellar. We heard the all clear alarm come out of the storm cellar, and everything's just tore all to pieces.
I'm Reed Binion reporting.
Now, India's only active volcano, the Barren Island volcano, has erupted again. According to the National Institute of Oceanography, the volcano did erupt on January 23rd of this year. The chief scientist at NIO stated, quote, it was a small eruption compared to the last major eruptions in 1991 and 1995. Ash clouds were visible during the day, but then once it got dark, scientists said you could see the lava pouring out of the volcano. Just 3 days later, the volcano was still having bursts of ash and smoke.
Well, space news with Tanner. NASA has been told to plan a trip to Mars, the Trump administration instructing NASA to begin planning the trip to the nearby Red Planet earlier this week. Right now, engineers at NASA are conducting tests to see if they will be able to send astronauts on the next Orion flight in 2019 with the first crewed launch in 2021. However, in order to reach Mars, NASA will need to finish building a heavy lift rocket that will be able to push the Orion rocket to Mars.
And have you ever dreamt of going to space? Well, your opportunity may be right around the corner. Elon Musk, founder and chief executive of SpaceX, announced Monday plans to send two paying private individuals on a trip to space. The journey will be a week long, taking its passengers around the moon and back to Earth. Musk hopes the trip will take place by the end of next year, saying that the two space tourists SpaceX has been in contact with are very serious about the opportunity. Musk did acknowledge the risks involved with the trip, but said the two-person crew crew will be trained for emergencies. The Dragon spaceship carrying the passengers will fly on autopilot for the duration of the mission, which will be as long as 400,000 miles round trip.
The Midwest has been dealing with severe storms and winter weather. Colorado has been dealing with a different type of weather. Many areas have been under red flag warnings and even watches with low humidities combining with strong winds. Fires can rage within these areas, especially in the drier areas. In El Paso County, Colorado, more than 5,000 acres have been burned and mandatory evacuations have been underway since Monday. Reports of damaged structures and phone outages have all been caused by the fires. A firefighter hurt his wrist while working, which thankfully has been the only injury reported by the fire.
All right, guys, and good morning, David. We are seeing very clear conditions here as well, as we're going to take a look here live on McKinley Avenue. Sunrise was just about an hour ago, so it's a beautiful look outside here on campus, but it's quite a chilly one. Currently, Muncie sitting at 26 degrees. West-northwest winds at 13 miles per hour, making it feel like 15 degrees. We are still in winter for at least a few more days here in Muncie. Currents across the state, 28 in Shelbyville, 26 in Bloomington, also in Indianapolis, and 25 in Kokomo. And we're going to see wind chills today. Pretty chilly. 16 in Shelbyville, 14 in Indianapolis. Feeling like 13. That's our cold spot there in Kokomo. Satellite and radar pretty clear this morning. You may have seen a few snowflakes on your windshield this morning, but nothing to worry about on the roads or anything. So pretty clear conditions. You saw those snow showers move out of our area, but we may still see some more snow showers tomorrow morning as well. We're also going to be talking about a little bit of a warm up, and we're also going to have some rain chances. That's all in a few minutes, just after your weather now.
Welcome back to Waking Up with Cardinal Weather. The time is now 8:23 a.m. Ball State's planetarium is getting an upgrade. The Charles W. Brown Planetarium, Indiana's largest, is going to be repurposed into a full-dome media production lab. The lab will be used to create, edit, and test content that will be used not only here at Ball State, but around the world. Officials say that not only will the new lab help students learn the technology involved, but it will also be used to create productions that will generate money for Ball State.
State University evacuated students from a residence hall this past week. Officials say that the halls will stay closed for the rest of the academic year due to a mudslide that is slowly creeping behind the residence hall. Students were first evacuated when they noticed the mudslide, and they continued as it continued to worsen. The rain kept accumulating. The area has received a total of 3 inches of rainfall already, and conditions are expected to worsen as the next storm system moves through, bringing more rain to the California area. The evacuated students were moved into other dorms and returned to the halls to collect anything that was left to grab.
And now when you think of this winter, you don't think of high snow total amounts, especially after a record warm week. Well, one large city in New York has officially reached 100 inches of snow this year. After the winter storm that hit the area February 15th through the 16th, Syracuse officially hit 100 inches, which is actually below their normal of 124 inches. Syracuse is the prime location for snow as it is affected by Alberta Clippers, Lake Effect Snow, and Nor'easters. The closest large city to be even close to 100 inches in the area is Rochester, New York, which has received 71 inches. Residents in the area say it doesn't feel like they have received 100 inches with all of this warm weather.
Even more NASA news today. NASA's Quest, or Quiet Supersonic Technology, just became a reality this week as wind tunnel tests just started for a big new project. The new Horizons Aviation Horizons X plane in its scale model stage will be subjected to winds near Mach 2 wind speeds, which is a breezy 950 miles per hour. This test will help figure out the aerodynamic performance and the propulsion system within the vessel itself. The X plane will be a passenger plane to travel near or at the speed of sound, making it the fastest transportation system in the world. These tests for Quest will go through the middle of 2017, and depending on funding, plans to put the prototype to life scale testing will begin in the year 2020.
Good morning, guys, and good morning to you at home if you're just waking up with us here this morning. We're seeing those few snow showers move out of our area into this morning, so you may have seen a few of those on your windshield, but we're seeing those move out of our area as we move through the rest of this morning to set up for a beautiful partly cloudy sky here. Again, those chilly temperatures we're waking up to, we're seeing 26 degrees here in Muncie, west northwest winds at 13, making it feel like 15 degrees here. Temperatures across the state are still pretty chilly as well, 28 in Shelbyville, 26 in Bloomington, Indianapolis, 23 in Lafayette, and 26 down in Terre Haute. Now, current winds are starting to get a little bit high out there, so we're seeing 13 mile per hour winds here in Muncie, 15 in Indianapolis, and 16 down in Shelbyville. I'll talk about some pretty high wind gusts later on in the forecast, but planning out today, we're seeing 27 degrees here at 9 a.m. We're seeing up to 30 here by lunchtime, but check out sunny skies and clear skies as we go throughout the evening. We'll be reaching a high today of around 34, 35 degrees today, so definitely a little bit chilly for this time of year, even though we're just getting into March. Spring is just around the corner, but we're going to have to still get through some winter temperatures as well. Tonight, we're going to reach a low of around 23 degrees today with clear skies. The winds will taper down a little bit to around 5 miles per hour. Now, precision cast showing clear, beautiful skies for most of your Friday, but as we move into Saturday, we see these snow showers move in. So this is Saturday at 8 a.m. So you may still see a few of those snowflakes on your windshield as you wake up Saturday morning, but the rest of Saturday looks pretty clear. So we're seeing clear skies for as we move through the rest of Saturday, and tomorrow we're seeing highs a little bit warmer. So we're starting to see that warm up come into play. 35 degrees with some snow chances in the morning, but we'll start to see those temperatures increase throughout the day. I talked about those pretty hefty wind gusts. We're seeing this Friday at 3 p.m. wind gusts up to 16 here in Muncie, 17 in Winchester and Portland. As we move through Saturday, we see pretty calm winds, but this is where they get pretty high. We're seeing Sunday at 2 a.m. 20 in Anderson, Marion also at 20, but this, we're going to see very high wind gusts near 30 miles per hour and even up to 35 and 40 miles per hour for Monday. Your 7-day forecast looks to be a little bit of a warmer one here. We're seeing Friday, again, 35 degrees. We'll start to see that warm up on Saturday, but those snow showers in the morning in the 44 degree range. Sunday, we are back up near 60, and we even got some thunderstorm chances there on Tuesday with a 60% chance of rain.
She's only 35 today. Just yes. This last week, it was, what, in the 70s?
Yes.
Crazy stuff. Well, after the break, we'll have your national forecast next. That's after your weather now.
Back now, taking a look at national weather. A lot of things that are on some people's mind. Spring break and how the travel forecast is going to be throughout the United States. Most people are headed south for the spring break, but taking a look at national radar, really high pressure working in throughout the middle part of the country as we are seeing another system starting to roll into the northwest here in Seattle. Rain showers prominent there in Washington and Oregon. That is our next low pressure system that will be working into the Midwest later on the week next week, come Monday into Tuesday. Taking a dive down south, finally some drier days for California. We are seeing some winter weather advisories for the upper parts of California and the mountainous regions. As we take a look in the upper Midwest, we are seeing some of the snow showers. This will affect us early tomorrow morning, as Kaylee had mentioned, for Saturday morning here in Muncie. But taking a look down to the south, where a lot of people will be traveling. Pretty warm out there, sunny skies, some rain showers off into the Gulf, but we will be seeing sunny skies across much of the south. So very nice weather conditions for the rest of the day there across the southern regions. And we are seeing that cold front moving down a little south, and we are seeing some freeze watches and warnings for upper parts of Georgia and South Carolina. So pretty cold down there, but like I said, it will not reach as far as Florida. So it will be nice and warm for you down there if you are traveled anywhere to the south. Some snow showers in the upper Appalachians, and if we take a look at some of the upper northeast, we are seeing some wind chill advisories. So pretty chilly up there, wind chill values up around negative 10 degrees, so pretty chilly up there if you're headed out there toward the northeast. So taking a look at national temperatures, 23 in Kansas City, 40 in Atlanta, 26 currently in Muncie. Taking a look off to the west, 56 in Los Angeles, 46 in Las Vegas. Pretty chilly out there. As we take a look at today's highs, if you are traveled anywhere today, it will be a warm one. If you are headed south, 65 in Pensacola, 66 in Dallas for a high, 67 in Los Angeles. As we take a look at Miami Beach, a very warm 73 degrees. So yes, those warm conditions there down in Florida, where most people are headed. Taking a look at Precision Cast, as Kaylee again had mentioned, those snow showers for Indiana. If you are traveled tomorrow morning, please be aware of that. We might be seeing an inch or less of snow accumulation. No problem expected, as that will melt later on in the afternoon. High pressure working in for the upper Midwest and for the south too. We will be seeing clear skies, and taking a look further into the day on Sunday, some clouds coming along for the middle part of the country. We'll be seeing some rain showers too, but then again, it will be clearing off for a great day. So guys, we will be seeing a very nice day here across Muncie. And if you are traveled south, guys, it's going to be nice out. So those... It's going to be really nice out, very warm temperatures, very nice time for spring break.
Definitely. Well,
that's right, David. I'm pretty jealous of the people traveling south for spring break.
Yes, of
me
course.
Me too.
Well, this morning, while we were counting down to the official start of spring break, some Ball State students got a head start on theirs.
That's right, Tanner. A class from Ball State is headed somewhere much warmer than here. This morning, we are joined by Robbie General, who is part of this class. Good morning, Robbie. How is the weather there right now and the traffic so far?
How's it going, guys? We're out here in Macon, Georgia, about an hour south of Atlanta. And the weather's a lot nicer here than it was when we left about 24 hours ago in Muncie, when we were hit with snow showers coming out. It was a little chilly this morning, but right now we're reaching up to the mid-40s. Supposed to get to the mid-60s here later today here in Macon. And I saw some locals complaining about the weather, but right now it's sunny, clear blue skies, not a cloud in the sky. So looking forward to a great day. We'll make it down to Sarasota later, where the high is 74 degrees. Once we get back here on I-475 and hop on 75 going southbound, popular highway for a lot of spring breakers going down to Florida and other areas down south trying to escape the snow flurries there in Muncie, Indiana. So weather has been great. Traffic, not bad at all. The only traffic we've hit was in Knoxville during rush hour yesterday and a little bit in Atlanta, but major cities. Other than that, it's been smooth sailing, not a lot of construction.
Robbie, this is a cool experience for you guys. You guys are a part of a class that's headed to Florida. Go ahead and tell me about that.
Yeah, we're down here with Ball State Spring Training, an immersive learning class here with Ball State. We have journalism and telecommunications students covering MLB teams down at spring training in the Grapefruit League, excuse me. We're covering about 5 to 6 teams along with Ball State sports as well. Baseball, they're going to be down there. So we have about 13 students and 2 faculty members going down to Sarasota later today. And we'll hopefully start working tomorrow. So Robbie General here live with Cardinal WX.
Well, Robbie, thank you very much for your time this morning. It is greatly appreciated. And we hope that you and the rest of your class have great success during your travels this spring. And guys, now it's time to see what's catching people's attention online with our Trending Now segment, and check out this first video. These Siberian tigers think that the drone taking footage of them is a big cat toy. They chase the drone around the compound in which they inhabit until one is able to get a hold of the drone, causing it to crash to the ground.
It's an expensive cat toy.
That is a very expensive cat toy, guys. And as you can see, they start gnawing on it there and chewing on it. And it ends up smoking here in just a second. They start pulling away.
I think
this is just a lesson to everybody, guys. You know, don't mess with Siberian tigers.
Yeah. How about tigers don't mess with electronics?
I think
they realized that wasn't food once it started smoking. Yeah.
They're like, I'm gonna back off.
Usually electronic drones are not chew toys.
That's all right, well, on to the next. This one comes from California. This great grandmother is celebrating her 100th birthday, but not with cake. She decides to show some dance moves to show that even she's been around for an entire century, she's still got some spunk. Look at her. She's just having a great time.
She is awesome. Living happier than ever, guys.
Can I be like that when I'm old?
Yeah.
I hope I'm lucky enough to make it to 100.
Yeah.
And if I am, to be able to be dancing around like that, that would be crazy.
I don't think
it'll happen. But moving on to Arizona, this man in the video throws a rock into a tree, and look what comes out. No, that is not smoke. It's pollen.
Gross.
The pollen blew out of the tree, forcing the rock thrower to retreat indoors before being covered with it. And guys, where are the bees when you need them?
I would be instantly sneezing.
My allergies would go insane.
Yep, I would have to leave the country, and it wouldn't be good.
It would not be a fantastic situation, but moving on here. Coming up, Kaylee and Molly will have your pop culture rundown. That's coming up after Weather Now.
It's always this weather now. Back now, 38 past the hour, 5 women scientists will be immortalized as the newest LEGO figures. The company unveiled its Women of NASA set this week, and it features women who played vital roles in the U.S. space program. This idea came from fans who proposed concepts for new sets through the LEGO Ideas series. The figures are Sally Ride, the first American woman in space, Nancy Grace Roman, who is known as the mother of the Hubble Space Telescope, and Mae Jemison, the first African American woman in space. Also included are Margaret Hamilton and Katherine Johnson, whose work helped put the first people on the moon. LEGO is still working on the final design for the price for the Women of NASA set, and that is set to be released either later this year or in early 2018.
Well, very cool story there, Tanner. Now moving on to some weather history. These are a few weather events that occurred on this day in years prior. First back to 1966, where a tornado hit in Jackson, Mississippi, killing 54 people. Moving to 1980, a coastal storm produced 25 inches of snow at Elizabeth City, North Carolina, and 30 inches at Cape Hatteras in Miami, Florida. The mercury dipped to 32 degrees. And lastly, small but intense low pressure system roared across west central Mississippi at 90 miles per hour in the morning. A tornado picked up a car and carried it 150 feet. It was then found in an unoccupied retirement home, and luckily we're not expected to have any destructive weather like that today, but one thing we can expect is a look at pop culture. Let's take it to Kaylee and Molly in the newsroom with our pop culture rundown.
Thanks, Emerson. We're going to talk about your pop culture rundown for today. So first, the highlight of IU basketball senior night wasn't the game itself, it was this proposal. During his senior speech, Colin Hartman dropped to his knee and proposed to his girlfriend, an IU cheerleader, in front of the home crowd. Hartman told Indy Star that this has been in the works for a while and he had a little help from head coach Tom Crean. IU went off to send off Hartman on a good note with a 63-62 win over Northwestern for his last home game. Isn't that sweet?
So cute.
It's adorable. You know, just like such an IU-filled life, you know, basketball player, cheerleader, proposal in front of the home crowd. What a great
it's
sight.
So sweet. Moving on to something much cuter, a new idea has been discovered with dogs in a tennis match. For the second year running,
Brazil has taken shelter dogs and trained them to pick them up with tennis balls and bring them back to team players. They won't be on duty for the whole tournament, which starts next week. Instead, they will be on duty for an exhibition match that is aimed to promote homeless dogs. All six dogs will be available for adoption.
You're right, Molly. That is definitely a super cute story.
It's pretty close to the engagement.
Definitely. Now, sad news for all the storm chasers out there. Bill Paxton, who played the infamous Bill Harding in the movie Twister, has passed away at the age of 61. To honor his memory, a large group of storm spotters spelled out his initials in the heart of Tornado Alley. John Wetter, who works at the National Weather Service, said, quote, "There are probably hundreds, if not thousands, of meteorologists today, myself included, who were impacted by the movie Twister and the role Bill played in that." Paxton passed away after surgery complications and was announced this past Sunday. Definitely some sad news, but what a great way to honor him there.
Yeah.
And then this past Sunday, Jimmy Kimmel hosted this year's Oscars. The four-hour-long broadcast showed the best in showbiz. Some of the highlights of this year's show included...
Viola Davis' inspiring speech, Jimmy Kimmel bringing a live tour bus into the show, a special edition Oscar-themed meme tweets, the actors of Hidden Figures bringing out one of the women that inspired the movie, Matt Damon being played off stage, and of course the big mess up of the night, the announcement of the Best Picture Award.
If you didn't quite make it to the end, then you missed out. While giving out the Best Picture Award, the presenter Jordan Horowitz accidentally said that La La Land had won. The crew was already giving their speech when he realized the mishap, and actually Moonlight won the Best Picture Award. Take a look at what happened.
This is not a joke. Moonlight has won Best Picture. Moonlight, Best Picture.
It was definitely an eventful night. Some of the big winners include animated feature film Zootopia.
Actress in the supporting role, Viola Davis. She has made history by being the first African-American woman to win an Oscar, Emmy, and Tony for her movie Fences.
Actor in the leading role, Casey Affleck.
For directing Damien Chazelle for La La Land, and he is the youngest director to ever win this award.
And finally, film editing, Hacksaw Ridge.
The Oscars are known for some of the best fashion seen all year. Here are some of the best dressed. Emma Stone was beautiful in this gold Da Vinci custom gown and Tiffany & Company jewels. That's gorgeous. And it looks just so great, and for her winning all those awards with La La Land.
So pretty. And so Hidden Figures star Terji P. Henson was a beautiful and off-the-shoulder navy velvet gown. Her stunning diamond choker, black clutch, and strap heels added the perfect touch to the dress.
Yeah, and here's Kristen Dunst looking stunning in a high-low Christian Dior dress and a diamond necklace and a gorgeous updo to complete her chic look. She also re-wore her favorite pumps.
Yeah, and that's Leslie Mann in a beautiful yellow dress that was designed by Zach Posen, Lorraine Schwartz jewelry, and Jimmy Choo shoes.
That's what's happening in this week in pop culture. Back to you guys at the desk.
All right, thanks Kaylee and Molly. Let's take a look at our spring countdown. It's just so close.
So close, guys. 17 days to spring, and I mean, it feels like spring right now, Tanner. Spring break starting in just a couple hours.
I know, I'm really excited about that. You know, spring break, it's gonna be a fun time this week.
That's right, I was talking with my roommate Jake last night about some spring break plans. Tanner, you have some really exciting spring break plans.
Yeah, going down to New Orleans, gonna have some fun on Bourbon Street, French Quarters, all that stuff. It's gonna be a great time.
Well, we wish you the best with that. And let's take one more look at the weather for today. Kaylee, what can we expect into the weekend?
Yeah, we're expecting very cooler temperatures for today. We're seeing 35 degrees today, but we're starting to see a warm-up start starting tomorrow. But you may wake up with a few snow flurries on your car if you're heading anywhere for spring break tomorrow morning. By Sunday, we'll be close near 60, but then that's when the rain chances come back into forecast for the beginning of next week.
Well, thank you very much, Kaylee. And that is all for this edition of Cardinal Weather. If you haven't already, follow us on Snapchat. Our username is CardinalWX.
And also be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter at CardinalWX. Have a great rest of your Friday and an awesome spring break.